Hey.
Remember me? I just thought we could talk about this.
You hide behind glass. Take all you see. Claim this. Take that. Make it all yours. Give nothing back.
All right. A bit heavy, but I agree. I could do better. Tomorrow morning. Give me the camera back. I'm a new man tomorrow, I promise.
You are part of the chain, Frank West. And I must break the chain.
No. You did it. God, I hate you. Okay. You know what? You hurt my student. Took my story. And now you've blown up my favorite camera.
So be it. Frank West was the zombie lord. Let's roll, weirdo.
All right, Vic? Vic! Where the hell are you going?
She left me! Again!
Clear off!
be a good time for that plan of yours.
Almost ready. Just kill some zombies.
Oh, Vic 2, Master Tactician.
Yeah! sarcasm is intact.
What? You're insane!
Frank West Journalism 101!
Brad, I need you at Kichiro Plaza. I need medical assistance now. Okay, come on. Stay with me, kid. Stay with me.
Everything. Camera and Barnaby's servers were wiped, and you blew the hard drive to a million pieces, so. Hey, you weren't really gonna shoot me, were you?
No, we're fatal.
Oh, like a leg?
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Fair enough. I deserve that. But listen, if it comes up again, can you aim for the right one? It's kind of a piece of shit anyway.
Frank. I'm really sorry about that.
Don't worry about it. I've had worse. And so will you. That's kind of the shit you go through when you're a good journalist, right?
What about being a great journalist?
What is that?
An SD card? From your camera?
You pulled it?
Yeah.
Before it blew up?
Mm-hmm. Go on.
What do you want for it?
Oh, jeez.
No, I mean it. I'll give you anything.
All right. I want the story. My words, your pictures. Big coverage, big impact.
Together, 50-50.
Yeah, 50-50.
I like the sounds of that. Plus mini golf.
Oh man, not the mini golf. Yeah, okay. Mini golf.
Well, now that you've sorted everything out, we need to get to the rendezvous point if we want to lift out of here.
You don't have to tell me twice.
Grab anything you need, and let me know when you're ready to go.
Packing enough heat there, Butch Cassidy.
I just fought a monster zombie lord. Did you notice that? The monster zombie lord?
I might have seen one. Just a little one.
Calder's toast.
Ooh, burn.
I'll get this gate open.
So, did your heart grow 3 sizes this Christmas, Frank?
Come on. We're good now, right? We're good?
Let's publish this story. Save the world. Then we'll be good.
You need to get out of Willamette first. Let's go. So, Miss Chu, normally I'd have to arrest you for the shit you pulled.
You'd have to catch me first, copper.
Oh, jeez.
Think you could be a journalist without guerrilla tactics?
Depends. Think the government will stop destroying our lives?
Zing! Well, they don't sound very happy.
Just over the sky bridge.
Oh, good. Nice and convenient. Did everyone get a souvenir?
PTSD counts, right?
It did for me.
I think we pissed them off. Come on! Give me a second with this door.
No, no, no! We don't have a second!
no!
Keep it together a bit longer!
If Frank could have it his way, this is where the story would end. He'd die a hero, sacrificing himself for the good of his friends. He wouldn't need to follow it up to see the mess that unfolded in the months after. But Frank's not here to tell the story his way. He can't load it up with spicy embellishments. Listening to his notes, I kind of wonder how this story would have gone when he told it later. Would he have defeated Fontana in single combat? Refused to conspire with the evil Dr. Blackburn? Added a sweet romance with the city engineer? I'm sure his second book would have sold as well as his first. But Frank's not here to tell his story. So he's got to trust me to do it. Whether he wanted it that way or not. And I say, the truth is better than fiction.